Before administering CUROSURF, it is important to ensure proper placement and patency of the endotracheal tube without interrupting mechanical ventilation. The endotracheal tube may be suctioned at the discretion of the clinician. Immediately before administration, it is recommended to adjust ventilator settings, considering the CUROSURF product labeling and your institution's protocols. Following any adjustments, the infant should be allowed to stabilize before proceeding with dosing. Per approved product labeling, CUROSURF may be administered intratracheally via two different methods, depending on the clinical situation. The primary method for administration is demonstrated in this video. Check the full prescribing information for details on the second method of administration. CUROSURF may be instilled through a 5-French end-hole catheter. The suspension should be slowly withdrawn from the vial using a sterile needle, at least 20 gauge, and 3 or 5 milliliter plastic syringe. Given that each vial is for single use only, it may be easiest to withdraw all content from the vial, discarding excess CUROSURF, so that only the total dose to be given remains in the syringe. Attach the 5-French catheter of the appropriate length to the syringe and advance the catheter into the endotracheal tube without going past the pre-measured depth. Fill the catheter with CUROSURF suspension. Discard excess CUROSURF through the catheter so that only the dose to be given remains in the syringe. Keep the infant in a neutral position with head and body in alignment without inclination with either the right or left side dependent. Immediately before CUROSURF administration, ventilate the infant with supplemental oxygen sufficient to maintain SaO2 greater than 92%. Insert the catheter into the endotracheal tube and instill the first aliquot of CUROSURF suspension, 1.25 milliliters per kilogram of birth weight. After the first aliquot is instilled, remove the catheter from the endotracheal tube and resume ventilation of the infant with supplemental oxygen until clinically stable. When the infant is stable, reposition the infant such that the other side is dependent and administer the remaining aliquot using the same procedures as the first aliquot. After completion of the dosing procedure, do not suction airways for 1 hour after surfactant instillation unless signs of significant airway obstruction occur. Transient adverse events seen with the administration of CUROSURF include bradycardia, hypotension, endotracheal tube blockage, and oxygen desaturation. These events require interrupting the administration of CUROSURF and taking the appropriate measures to alleviate the condition. After stabilization, dosing may resume with appropriate monitoring. After completion of the dosing procedure, resume usual ventilator management, monitoring and adjusting ventilator settings as needed. Following administration, CUROSURF demonstrates a rapid onset of action, affecting both oxygenation and lung compliance. In a clinical trial, CUROSURF has been shown to work within 5 minutes. Therefore, it is best to remain at the bedside following administration. Infants should receive frequent clinical and laboratory assessments monitoring oxygen status, airway pressure, and respiratory rate. During this time, it's important to adjust oxygen and ventilator settings as respiratory status improves or if you detect acute deterioration, cyanosis, or bradycardia. It's important to note that suctioning is permitted 1 hour after administration. Suctioning before 1 hour is not recommended unless signs of significant airway obstruction occur. If the infant still requires surfactant, a repeat dose of CUROSURF can be given. Repeat doses of CUROSURF should be administered at 1.25 milliliters per kilogram of birth weight, or 100 milligrams per kilogram. This is half of the initial dose of CUROSURF. It is important to note that 3 total doses of CUROSURF for a maximum recommended total dose of 5 milliliters per kilogram can be administered. This represents the sum of the initial and up to 2 repeat doses. Important safety information. CUROSURF poractant alfa intratracheal suspension is intended for intratracheal use only. The administration of exogenous surfactants, including CUROSURF, can rapidly affect oxygenation and lung compliance. Therefore, infants receiving CUROSURF should receive frequent clinical and laboratory assessments so that oxygen and ventilatory support can be modified to respond to respiratory changes. CUROSURF should only be administered by those trained and experienced in the care, resuscitation, and stabilization of preterm infants. Transient adverse effects seen with the administration of CUROSURF include bradycardia, hypotension, endotracheal tube blockage, and oxygen desaturation. These events require stopping CUROSURF administration and taking appropriate measures to alleviate the condition. After the patient is stable, dosing may proceed with appropriate monitoring. Correction of acidosis, hypotension, anemia, hypoglycemia, and hypothermia is recommended prior to CUROSURF administration. Surfactant administration can be expected to reduce the severity of RDS, but will not eliminate the mortality and morbidity associated with other complications of prematurity. Pulmonary hemorrhage is a known complication of premature birth and very low birth weight, and has been reported with CUROSURF. The rates of common complications of prematurity observed in a multicenter single-dose study that enrolled infants 700 to 2,000 grams birth weight with RDS requiring mechanical ventilation and fraction of inspired oxygen greater than or equal to 60% are as follows for CUROSURF 2.5 milliliters per kilogram, 200 milligrams per kilogram, N equals 78, and control, N equals 66, no surfactant, respectively. Acquired pneumonia, 17% versus 21%. Acquired septicemia, 14% versus 18%. Bronchopulmonary dysplasia, 18% versus 22%. Intracranial hemorrhage, 51% versus 64%. Patent ductus arteriosus, 60% versus 48%. Pneumothorax, 21% versus 36%. And pulmonary interstitial emphysema, 21% versus 38%. Please see full prescribing information. For more information on CUROSURF, poractant alfa, intratracheal suspension, visit www.curosurf.com or call 888-466-6505.